ஓய்லர் பர்னர் ருடேன்ஸ் ரோட்டரி கப் டைப். This is a vertical type water tube boiler made by Osaka Boiler Manufacturing Limited. Design pressure is 9.9 bar, working pressure is 9 bar. Evaporation rate is 12,000 kg per hour. Before starting work, ensure that boiler has changed over to diesel oil. This is the burner control panel. The preparations before starting the job includes: put off the fuel oil pump, put off the burner operation to stove position, put off the forced draft and primary air fan power source. Close the fuel oil cube closing valve. Close the fuel oil inlet, outlet and bypass valves of the flow meter. Removal of pilot burner. Disconnect all the connections including spark ignition electrode supply. Take out the pilot burner. Open up the screws and take out the burner cover to get work on the burner nozzle easily. Now, take out the pilot burner nozzle. Open up and clean the burner nozzle. It contains a small filter. Clean the parts with compressed air. Clean the electrode tip. Assemble back the pilot nozzle. Check the distance between the electrode tips. The distance is of very important because if the distance is not correct, it can cause ignition failure. Mounting the pilot burner back on boiler. Put back all the connections including the spark electrode supply without interchanging. Now, opening the furnace door for main burner, that is the rotary cup burner maintenance. Pull out the main burner assembly. Pull the lock and open the door. This is the rotary cup. It looks very dirty. Now open the burner motor belt cover. Lock the main shaft by fitting the H configurator tool over the spanner seats on the main shaft pulley and on the burner oil connection head. This is to prevent the main shaft from rotating while working. Remove the deflected disc in the center of the rotary cup. Loosen and remove the locking bolt. Fit the rotary cup remover tool over the rotary cup hub and tighten its center screw until the cup comes off the shaft. Loosen the Allen screws of the rotary cup hub cover. Push out the rotary cup hub. Remove the rotary cup hub cover. Take out the hub sleeve. Keep the assembly in such a position to work on the primary air nozzle with ease. Removal procedure of burner primary air nozzle. Take out the screws holding the air nozzle. These are the marking lines for correct remounting. Push out the primary air nozzle with a soft material. The burner oil distributor removal procedure is not shown in this video, but the burner oil distributor can be removed after dismantling of rotary cup. Use the long hexagon wrench to unscrew its four mounting screws. Thereafter, the distributor can be pulled off. Clean all the parts in fresh diesel oil. Mount back primary air nozzle. Apply a thin coat of grease. Firmly tight all the four Allen screws. Rotary cup burner assembly. This is the exploded view of the rotary cup burner. Change the O-ring with a new one. Assemble back in the reverse order of disassembly. Apply a thin layer of grease on the shaft taper. Before remounting, make sure that the tapered seat in the cup as well as the taper on the main shaft is clean. Tighten the locking bolt. Tighten the deflector disc in place. Measure the distance between primary air nozzle and rotary cup front end. As the maintenance on rotary cup is finished, we will close back the door. Remove the edge tool from the shaft. Mount the cover back. Clean the flame detector. If the flame detector is dirty, it will give flame failure alarm. Clean the fuel oil inlet filters. Remove and clean the filter in diesel oil pilot line. Open the flow meter valves and the quick closing valves. Now we will fire the boiler. Put the fuel oil pump in auto mode. Put on the FD fan and the primary air fan. Burner operation mode to auto and then to auto on so that the burner will be on standby. Now our boiler has been fired. First it will fire in the pilot line and then it will change to the main line. You can see that the pilot burner pressure gauge. Now it has cut off and the main burner starts.